Bring it on.
Those wise enough to accept it.
No, not astral knowledge, you simpleton. Psychic domination. And that still won't be possible until you destroy Desmond's jamming device.
No need to worry, Enlightened One. We shall reconsecrate the mansion and remove the impurities obstructing your perfect guidance.
Yes, fine. Go destroy the house and its impurities. Just stop that jammer, and I'll be free of you morons once and for all.
Yes, we shall be free of all limitations. Thank you, Master. We shall be the instrument of your mighty reel. Hello? You are a fellow seeker of the higher planes, perhaps. What brings you here?
I was drawn to your eternal wisdom.
How wonderful! Perhaps you shall be the one who can clear the Holy Land of its destructive presence. Oh. But the Transcendent Master will want to hear this. And as one so obviously led by visions, it is your right and honor to tell him yourself. After all, it is he who makes all true decisions about the spiritual growth of a tribe, including the decision to cleanse the mansion.
May I meet the Transcendent Master?
It is very rare that others are permitted to commune with the Master. Many are too foolish to understand the great truths of his higher mind. But I sense in you great potential. Perhaps you have what is needed to accept his teachings and grow from his wisdom. He manifests here, high on a ledge in the great sea cave's well. Seek him out, and all shall be revealed.
You're the mouse that was scurrying around here. Not much to look at, but at least you're not drooling all over yourself. I can work with that. Now then, perhaps you can be more useful than that simpering spiritualist and his tribe of idiots.
What the hell are you?
What you are interacting with is merely a holographic projection, and a clumsy one at that. But it's all I can manage at the moment. As for myself, you gaze upon one of America's greatest minds. Preserved through the miracles of science. Much more elegant than shambling on as some rotting corpse for all eternity, don't you agree?
How did you come to lead this tribe?
Jackson believes me to be some kind of god. You'd think that would be good, but his interpretations of my commands leave something to be desired. Regardless, I trust you can be more effective than he has been. I need your help on an important task. There's a troublesome ghoul who lives in Calvert Mansion. I need him destroyed and his jamming device neutralized. Immediately.
What have you got against the ghoul?
More than you could possibly imagine with your squishy pink mind. But the only pressing matter at the moment is a device in his possession. He has a jammer that limits my projection range to this pathetic cave. Remove that and I can extend my reach so much further. Killing Desmond would be a nice plus, but I'm sure we can get around to that later.
Did you tell the tribals to attack the mansion?
Of course I did, but that moron thought it was one of his adult visions. The real goal was to destroy the ghoul's jamming device. Honestly, those fools aren't worth the meat they're made of. A minion that can't follow directions is no use at all.
What do you know about Desmond?
Desmond. That bag of bones and bio will pay dearly for his trespasses. Were it not for his interference, I would still have a body. Still, his absence has only honed my brilliance, so perhaps I owe him my thanks. An appreciation I'll show in the form of a quick and messy death. Ha ha ha!
I have to go now.
Yes, away with you!
Fucking kill!
Got it.
All it takes is a steady hand, eh?
Something like that. Sweet. Thank you.
now, you're gonna be sharing that with both of us, right?
Hey there.
Well, if it ain't my favorite out-of-towner.
Let's talk about the tonic.
We need to gather up the ingredients.
This enough punga fruit for you?
I see you sprung for the refined fruit. Good for you, sweetie.
Let's talk about the tonic.
We need to gather up the ingredients.
I've got the yeast with me.
I see. Thank you kindly for these.
Let's talk about the tonic.
We need to gather up the ingredients.
I've got batteries.
I thought so. Those things do carry a smell, don't they? Let me take them off your hands, then.
I want to know more about you.
Why, I'm just folk. What more is there?
Why did you fake being sick?
And here I thought you were a quick one. Look, sweetie. I reckon you'd have shot me as soon as you walked in here if you weren't a kind soul, or at least an enterprising type.
Did you build that still yourself?
That old thing? It's been in my family for years and years. Well, before the bombs, there was a time folks couldn't get no tonic by law, and my family did okay helping them get what they needed.
What do you think of Point Lookout?
Things aren't wonderful, but I reckon it's hard all around. My family's lived hereabout since, well, before the war, and I reckon we'll be here a long time yet.
Let's change the subject.
I thought you'd never ask.
Your still could stand to be fixed up.
Could it now? I suppose you'd know how to see to that, wouldn't you?
Actually, I already took care of it.
Well, I'll be. Here, let me give you something for your trouble.
I have to go now.
Don't be a stranger now.
How's it going?
My, look at you.
I'm listening.
Enough of this slog.
You have a good sleep. I know I did.
Yeah, I guess so.
What I wouldn't give for a good stiff drink.
Understandable.
Than a smoking gun and a pocket full of caps.
Caps are pretty important. Yes.
Whoa, you hear that?
I think we're done for now. Let's get on with it. Let's do this. Good riddance. Come to Mama. Excellent. Mine now. Okay, let's get started. Let's just get this over with. I'm glad that's over with. Such pretty eyes.
I don't ask for much. Just need a full bottle and some bones to break.
Is that all?
All this rest is making me tired.
Well, I hope you're not disappointed.
You fishing for a snog?
Possibly.
Making noise from your petrol tank.
Why do you say that? Get out of here.
I knew that little bastard was behind all this. After all these years, he stuck his head out. And this is my chance to cut it off. Figuratively speaking, of course. Him. I should have known. My old rival. so close to his family home. Only he would be so stupid. There was once a man, Professor Calvert. The Calverts owned half of Maryland, back when there was a Maryland to own. Members of the Calvert family were influential all over the world. They practically owned a deed to the U.S. government. In their best days, there were no less than 3 Calvert family senators, 7 members of the House, and 2 governors. They even had a top candidate for president, until that scandal with the dog forced him to drop out of the race. I was particularly proud of that one. Calvert is my old rival. Centuries we played this game. I knew he'd be stupid enough to hide so close to his family home. It's not a matter of hate. It's a matter of destiny. He is my enemy, and I do not suffer any bastard who opposes me to live. I knew he was here, and it is my intent to find him and call down a righteous fucking hammer on his head. Figure as if I mean his head. Of course, I fucking want you to do something else. You don't expect me to trawl around this mud hole myself, do you? Or what? You think I haven't been shot before? Think that you, over the thousands who have tried, can take me down? Best wise the hell up and play along. I'll get what I want and you'll get rich. Men can go about our separate goddamn ways. So, those half-wits are getting messages from the professor, right? So, he's off somewhere broadcasting to them. But without those buggers to do things for him, he can't do much for himself. So, we cut off his ability to talk to him, and he'll need to try harder. Maybe then I can find the squishy little worm and finish him off for good. If I know Professor Calvert, and I do, he's using a high-frequency cognitive sign broadcast. I have the perfect device to jam up his little talk box. All you need to do is take you to the highest point on the shore and install it. Easy, right? Right, attach it to the bottom car, then turn it on and spin the jammer to the top. No fucking problem. I'll watch from here and turn it on. Then we'll see where our little professor is. Now go.
Hey, boy. Nothing worth mentioning. We'll all be better off without you around.
I always have time for you, you know.
Hey, thanks. Suits me fine.
I'm gonna be pissed if I get soaked.
Understandable. Not gonna happen.
Only thing better than getting pissed is picking a fight. Am I right?
I'm not sure. Sweetie, you like my nose, right?
It's been too long since I picked a fight.
Sorry. Sounds really rough.
Gum. Not leaving here in one piece. My pleasure.
They're onto us. Kill them!
My pleasure.
If it's fun you're looking for, you found the woman of your dreams.
Absolutely. Hey there.
I knew it. I knew that little bastard was behind. Figure. I fucking want you to do something else. You don't expect me to crawl around this mud hole myself, do you? Or what? The best one. So, but without those buggers, so we cut off.
Sure.
If I know the purpose, I have a purpose. Easy, right? Right.
Mm-hmm.
I'll watch from here and now go. It's my little helper. Don't you have a job to do?
Let me know if you find some spare ammo.
I'll see what I can do. Not gonna happen. The feeling's mutual.
I don't mind hooking it as long as there's some excitement at the end of the road.
If I were you, I wouldn't drink a drop of that.
What if I did? You're kidding, right? I eat ginger for breakfast. Tastes like chicken.
Die, you scum!
Get him.
Yeah.
ammo, caps, whatever you find, don't forget to share.
I guess it can't hurt. Hey.
I knew it! I knew that little bastard was behind all this! After all these years, he stuck his head out. This is my chance to cut it off. Figuratively speaking, of course. Him. Him. There was once members of the Calvert family who were influential all over the world. They practically owned a deed to the U.S. government. In their best days, there were no less than 3 Calvert family senators, 7 members of the House, and 2 governors. They even had a top candidate for president, until that scandal with the dog forced him to drop out of the race. I was particularly proud of that one. Calvert, it's not mine. Pick it. Him. Him. Of course. So, Bartle, so. If I have the perm. Easy. Attach it to the bottom car, and turn it on and spin the jammer to the top. No fucking problem. I'll watch from here and turn it on. Then we'll see where our little professor is. Now go.
I think I might have pulled a muscle or something.
Understandable.
I wouldn't give my good.